Where's the shooter?
At the hospital with Finn. The girl, Luna, is in interview. She is pretty shaken up.
How did they know that you were picking her up?
Well, Amaro thinks that they were followed to the precinct.
Amaro?
Yeah, he was the arresting officer.
They shot at cops right outside of the station, so they want us to know they're crazy.
You must be my new detective.
Dominic Carisi, Jr. Call me Sonny. I brought Zeppeli.
I asked for an experienced, empathic detective, and they sent you.
I'm way experienced. Sensitive and moody, too, and I can do that whole empathy thing.
Where are you from?
Staten Island SVU for 2 months, and Brooklyn for almost a month, and then Queens last week.
So they love you wherever you go, Carisi.
Call me Sonny.
Thank you so much for meeting me for lunch. I've been going stir crazy on maternity leave.
How's being a mom?
You were right. It's the greatest thing ever.
See, I told you.
Yeah.
You get any sleep?
No, look at me. I was up till 4 a.m. last night.
What, is she 6 weeks?
Mm.
You got to fervorize her soon. Not really the same. You got to call my sister. It's like 2 or 3 nights. The baby basically cries nonstop, but then they start to self-soothe.
Okay, then you come over and do it. Oh, see? So here we go.
No, I got this. I got this.
It's okay.
Hey. Come on, that's a good girl. Shh. You say the secret is you got to bounce from your knees. They love that. Shh. You know, Rollins, a guy commits a murder, right? He does his time and then he's out and about. But a rapist? No, nobody wants to live next to him. No matter what he does, he is never going to be trusted again. He's in purgatory.
Are you all right? Hey. Why don't you come over for dinner? Hang out with Jessie. Yeah? I promise you the minute she starts wailing, it will clear your head of everything else.
Dinner, huh?
Yeah. Come on.
Did you learn to cook?
No, I didn't learn to cook. You're gonna cook. We're gonna shop on the way.
You should probably go check on Chucky, huh?
Oh, no, we didn't.
Oh, they're on book.
Okay. Thanks.
What the hell? I'm sorry. Don't tell me. Tell Missy here.
Missy, I'm sorry. Let me get you guys a round of drinks.
What the hell did you say?
Excuse me?
You can't just buy me off with a beer and say Mrs. Fines. Come on.
That was so much fun. I haven't had that much fun since Christmas 2005. This is where I get off.
You know, there's something nice about not having to always act like a cop. You know, we could have taken all those guys, you know?
Oh, I know we could.
You know what? You're a hell of a pawn.
You too.
Nah, I mean, you got my back. I can't tell you how much I appreciate that. Not just tonight.
I'm beat.
Yeah, shut up. All right, good night.
Okay, good night.
Hey, Liv, tell Raphael not to worry about extradition Heather Wade, the hearing, because she wants to come to New York. Yeah, we're picking her up now. She'll be on the road in 15. Okay, got it.
All right, you're so bad.
Aside from not sleeping,
you worry. You worry about your kid getting sick or breaking a bone or, God forbid, getting hit by a taxi. And it's like you're holding your breath underwater, like every day. And then you get to tuck them in and kiss them goodnight. You get to breathe out again. I can't imagine that.
Hey,
you know?
Hey, it's all right. Hey.
SVU. You here to see the state psych for Sam Conway?
Yeah.
She's having another kid, you believe that?
Is that three?
Five.
Wow.
Yeah. Rollins, why didn't you tell me?
Tell you what?
All right.
Sonny, I didn't know how. But don't start asking me questions right now. And don't go Catholic on me, okay?
You want me to get you something else?
No, I'm not hungry, I guess.
Hey, what's up, Lou? Okay. Hey, got it. I'm on it. So, Liv wants us to bring Brittany and Laura back. We got to go over the story again. Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm going into labor. I feel a little lightheaded.
That's normal. You're going to have a baby. You're doing great, Amanda, but you've got plenty of time, so don't worry. Okay. How are you holding up, Papa?
Well, oh, no, I'm not
Doctor,
there.
They need you in 1017. We don't have a room for you yet, so just give us a few minutes.
What about the epidural?
Or a lobotomy.
Oh. Okay.
Don't leave me.
I'm not going anywhere.
Amanda?
Al, what are you doing here?
The hospital called. You go into labor and you don't tell me?
Oh,
things happen pretty fast.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, thank you for being here. Carisi, right?
Yeah, that's right.
I appreciate it.
Don't mention it.
I just want to take a deep breath.
Good idea, but we might not have a whole lot of time. Second babies can be a surprise.
Thanks, Al.
In fact, better safe than sorry. Let's see. This is not exactly how I saw this happening. But, before the baby comes, I would like to make you an honest woman.
That's okay. No, it's okay.
I should go.
No, stay.
No. Stay. I want the whole world to hear this. Amanda, we created a life together. Now it is my greatest wish that you, me, Jesse, Franny, and baby Pollock create a family together. Amanda Rollins, will you marry me?
She's so beautiful.
Thanks.
What's her name?
Billy.
Billy, nice.
Yeah.
Jesse and Billy. You like your new sister, Jesse?
I love her.
Hey.
There you are.
What did I miss?
Look.
She's perfect.
Bless us. Just family. Carisi, and you're pulling an Irish goodbye?
I didn't want anybody to make a fuss or anything, so...
Mission accomplished. How you feeling?
I'm nervous. I had to turn in my gun today. This whole thing is a big leap. It's risky, but if I don't make this move now, I'm...
Yeah, I hear you. Hey, before you leave me, one last drink.
What did you think would happen when you moved over to that place? Because it's all about politics, which is not your strong
suit. Well, I'm just doing my job. I'm not paying attention.
Are you? Because it seems like you're more worried about your boss than you are about Chloe.
Actually, what I'm more worried about is the DV with the battered wife. Who's not cooperating?
I'm worried about the trans girl who was assaulted by a corporate lawyer in a case that we're never gonna make.
We're not. Not with that attitude. And you know what? Everyone is worried. We're all nervous. We're swamped. We're drowning because you left.
Oh, okay. So that's what this is about. Did I left? I had to go. It was my shot.
Okay, come on. But I would be fine if you were right here beside me. You said you're my partner. You walked out on me.
You said that you were happy
for
me.
And you believe me? How stupid are you?
Hey, guys. I'm on the phone with the deputy chief, so whatever is going on between you...
Nothing's going on.
Get over it. Now.
Less than an hour, okay? Yeah, I can't wait to be home. All right, tell the girls thanks.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Out of the bed.
But you always spoon me. And what about my siblings?
One sister, but you're not in touch.
She's trouble, you can say that.
But hot.
Hey.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Mr. and Mrs. Albadine, nice to meet you.
Hi.
Now, before I talk to you separately, I want to get to know you both as a couple.
That's why we're here.
So how'd you two meet?
Well, it's a funny story. We worked together for years, and I just always thought he was attractive, you know, funny, smart.
But it wasn't until I changed jobs that we could acknowledge that we had feelings for each other.
Okay, I guess. Tell me more about how you spend your time.
Hey.
Hey, Rollins.
A rough day in court, huh? Sketch of you was really good.
Did Benson send you here to buck me up?
No, I just thought I'd check in on you. I got a sitter tonight. Thought I could drive you home, stop for a drink or three.
I got a lot of loose ends with Sir Toby and paperwork with the Davies case. Only way out is through, right? Besides it. I'd probably be lousy company right now.
Rain check.
Yeah.
Hang in there, Dominic.
That sounds great. Listen, I'll meet you there in an hour. Yeah, me too. All right, bye. Hey.
We got lucky with these men. Recovered text to Antonio, cash withdrawals the day Saranda went missing.
This is great. This plus Sam and Antonio's testimony, we could charge Eastman with kidnapping and murder. Thanks, Rollins.
Mm-hmm. I just got here. What, you got a hot date or something?
Actually, this is someone I... Look, Rollins, I know you and I... I've been meaning to tell you.
I'm so sorry. This is an Atlanta number.
Yeah, go ahead.
This is Amanda Rollins. I see. Yeah, of course. I will see what I can do. Thank you for calling.
Well, what is it? Everything okay?
Yeah, that was his doctor, my father. He had a stroke.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry.
They just said he's all alone there.
What about his wife?
She couldn't handle quarantine with him. And they can't get a hold of her. She's 25. I mean, I guess we know how that goes.
Okay. Amanda, you need to get on a plane to Atlanta.
I can't. Jesse, Billy, my job.
No, I'll call your mom. She can watch the girls. I'll tell Liv what's going on. Come on, you need to go. Okay? It's gonna be okay.
At the place. No and no. You wanted me to bring him a six-pack of Bud and a carton of cigarettes.
Must mean he's feeling better.
Yeah, honestly, I don't even know why I brought him up here. It was a 12-hour car ride, him bitching the entire time. He just kept working me in a cave.
He's your dad. He's got nobody
else. Anyway, how long can it take to regain muscle strength? A couple weeks?
It's not a straight line, Rollins. I had a stroke, and she...
No, but the doctor said this is a mini stroke.
Yeah, either way, okay, you can't predict recovery. Being disabled is the one minority group you can fall into at any time.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Carisi.
You're welcome.
Right here.
Cannolis. Very thoughtful. Evie, check these for the girls.
Okay.
Jesus, everybody here is so old.
Okay.
I'm fine. She told you it was a mini stroke.
Yeah, she did, sir.
They hadn't put me on bed rest, I wouldn't need rehab.
Well, we're gonna get going, Dad. Do you need anything else? No beer or smokes, but.
You're as fun as your mother.
Mm-hmm.
You got yourself a wonderful woman here, Sonny. After all I put her through, coming down to help her old man, blood is thicker than water.
Actually, Dad, we're not.
Oh, of course you're not. What did I tell you last time? You and your losers. Your problem? You meet a nice guy, you think he's too good for you.
Okay. Be good. You said you wanted to tell me something before I went to Atlanta.
You got enough on your plate.
Yeah. What the hell am I gonna do with Jim?
Well, his wife's here. Why don't you let her deal?
No, I saw the look in his eyes. He doesn't want anything to do with her. Yeah, and my dad is a force. I've seen him drunk, manic, high on life. I've seen him angry, but I've never seen him scared. I don't know if I can do this. Carisi, be the grown up.
You've been the grown up for a while now, Amanda Rollins.
You lucked out, right? You were so worried about the ceremony that you didn't even have to do it.
I spent all night rewriting it. I was kind of looking forward to it. I got the whole thing down to 2 minutes.
I'd like to hear.
Nah, come on. Yeah. Really?
As long as it's under 2 minutes.
Okay. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here to witness and celebrate the union of Phoebe Baker and Finn Tutuolo. Finn and Phoebe were each other's first partners over 20 years ago. And a partnership is a lot like a marriage. You fight, then you make up. But at the end of the day, you always have each other's backs. And if you had to, you'd take a bullet for each other. And a bond like that, that never goes away.
Wait. Wait a second, are you crying?
No, I don't cry at weddings. If I was, it was just because I know how they end up.
Uh-huh. You have a cry, huh?
That's better. Spare you the rest. It's kind of hokey anyway.
Carisi.
What? Saw us.
Nobody saw us.
This is not a great idea.
It's the courthouse at 10 p.m. It's not like the cleaning crew is gonna bust us.
Is this even real?
It seems like it is.
And tomorrow?
Councilor Carisi?
Yeah, sorry I'm late.
Anya Avital, Southern District.
Good to meet you.
The rest of the team is waiting. Oh, lipstick.
What?
You had fun at the wedding, huh?